In part one, the tactic worked absolutely brilliantly, and with no input and just allowing the assistant to go through the season, it took Newport to second in the Sky Bet League Two. So I was hoping that in part two, the tactic would do pretty much the same. But the results left me somewhat speechless for a while. But we've analysed what happened and made some conclusions. Let's go and kick some balls. Hello and welcome back to FM22 with Old Man Phil. And welcome to this second part of this unique little test that we're doing with RDF's Salzburg tactic. Now in part one, you will have seen that it worked absolutely perfectly and without any input, without any transfer activity, and just allowing the assistant to go through the season, we managed to get to second. And that was quite remarkable. It's just the tactic that took the team to that position. Before going on, if you are new, then please subscribe, watch, like, and comment, and help us to support the very worthwhile cause that you can see scrolling above. In the second part, we've chosen to do this later on in a save. So we're just going to insert the tactic into the Newport County save that I've just finished. And we're going to see if the same results occur and that we get remarkable improvement just by using the tactic. And we have taken Newport all the way up to the Premier League, and we've been two seasons in the Premier League, and we finished 12th in both seasons. And pretty much it's a combination of not being able to buy elite players, the budget not being enough, and also the club reputation not being high enough and nobody wanting to come and play for us because they didn't think we were a very good team. And so 12th, I think, in the Premier League is about as high as we're going to get them. We have been dabbling in the transfer market because players wanted to leave. We needed to move players on. So this isn't just like a clean save. We're just going to continue as we normally would. We brought in players like Kerr Smith, a young boy who's just a squad player. Baiji, who we got in, a striker from Benfica. We brought him in for 8.25 million. Looks the business again, a young boy, and could develop into a very, very good player. Garcia, a right back, we paid a lot of money for him, £28 million, over several installments. But I like his physicals and his mentals, and I think he could be a good addition to the squad. Ignacio Pinto, we brought in from Borussia Mönchengladbach for £30 million. Bit of a gamble this, but again, he looks like he could become a very, very good player. He's just 23 years old, has got more development in front of him. And I think he could become a very, very good player. And he cost us £30 million. Lazanko, an attacking midfielder, we brought in for £6 million. It's an investment player. We could sell him on for a lot more. And if he develops, he could become a very, very good midfielder. And then a goalkeeper, Anthony Knock, young backup goalkeeper, who I think will be knocking on the door to the first team sooner than we thought. We've done transfer business because we had a lot of players we had to get rid of. Isaac Smith went to Aberdeen on a free, Aaron Lewis, Zach Swanson, Jensen Weir, and Manogo went out on loan. They're simply not good enough to be in this, anywhere near this team. Mohamed Bilen wanted to move, and so we sold him to Young Boys for £10 million, almost a £10 million profit. And Jan Rita, the young wonder kid we signed at the beginning of last season, he was always going to move on, and we got £30 million for him. So we have done some transfer activity, but we do have some money left as well and some wage budget. And we do need another midfielder to bring in before we start the test. So we'll update you on that at the end of the transfer window. But really, this is now about finding out whether you can just put a tactic into an already existing save. We are 8 seasons in, and will it have the same effect? This is a struggling Newport team. We have had to work really hard to keep them where they are. And could this RDF's Salzburg 4-3-2, 4-3-1-2 actually improve on the 12th that we've actually been achieving through that really hard graft of maintaining their presence in the Premier League. So can we just install a really good tactic like this one now and let the players just work that tactic? Excuse me. And we'll get some good results out of it. The difference between this Newport side and the Newport side that we had did it, the first Newport side, these boys can play Carrilero, and they have and they are very able in all areas to play the Carrilero. Tukum and Vitek and Hackney also can play as a Carrilero, and many of the others coming in like James Garner. He is a natural Carrilero. So we do have the players this time who fit the role absolutely perfectly. So if the tactic is what will make the difference, then these boys will absolutely love doing it. We did find our midfielder in James Garner. It cost us a lot of money, but again, I like the look of his physicals and mentals. His passing ability is extremely good. Passing and vision are very, very good. His first touch isn't bad either. So he could work out to be a very, very good addition to the midfield. And we brought him in for £32.5 million, rising to 35. So we spent all our money. We're a little bit over on the wage budget, but hey ho, it's just a trial. And looking at the team, it's much stronger than it was last season, and so I'm expecting that this tactic will give us a better performance than we had 12th last time out. We didn't get off to the greatest of starts. Brighton was a tame 0-0 draw. We then lost to Liverpool by 3-1, and then a tame home 1-1 draw against Leeds. But in between, we had a 7-1 victory over Cambridge in the Caribou Cup. And so I think really now we should go and have a look at what actually happened. Excuse me, I have a bit of a throat cold. And you can see that we finished 16th with just 32 points. We won only 7, drew 11, and lost 20 games. We have a goal difference of minus 28. And if we look at what actually happened through the season as it went on, it just got worse and worse and worse. And through November, December, we didn't win a game. January, we only managed to win one game, and that was in the FA Cup. And February, we lost all our games. And in fact, as the season progressed, and I kept glancing as it was moving along, I kept wondering, is this the time when I'm going to lose my job? Because it kept saying at the top that the manager's job at Newport was under threat. But at the end of the season, somehow we managed to rescue it. We won 3 and drew 3 from April. And somehow the team managed to save my job and to avoid relegation. They were bottom of the league right up until the beginning of April. And somehow they managed to do it. In terms of player performance, it really wasn't very good. Bai Xi, the Chinese striker we bought, and Garcia were the only two who got above 7 in the ratings. And Bai Xi got 19 goals. Charlie McNeil chipped in with 14. I always expect him to get a few. And Trott, who spent most of the season injured by the look of it, he got 11 goals as well. In terms of assists, it was Lascano, the young attacking midfielder, who topped the charts with the assists. And Baji, you have to call him Baji, Onion Baji, he chipped in with 8 assists, and Trott with 7 assists. But despite all that, what's really interesting is that the squad dynamics is really, it's really good, and my managerial support is still excellent. Team cohesion's good, but we have a number of players who want to leave, and obviously because they simply weren't getting any game time. There was no rotation going on, but nobody's actually supporting them in their cause. So. And despite facing the sack all the way through most of the season, the board are now obviously very pleased. And we seem to have somehow managed to satisfy the board. They don't even have anything in particular interest to be critical of the moment. The only thing we failed in was reaching the FA Cup fifth round. And everything else we passed and they're pleased with. And so... our job was saved, but only just by the skin of our teeth from April onwards. So we have to think about what we have learned from that experience. And there's a number of things that we have to think about. And like, firstly, the main thing to think about is that this is just a computer game. It's not real life. And like every computer game, it's a puzzle and a series of puzzles that get more difficult from level to level. And so a season one is the most easy or the easiest of all the levels, then that becomes, then putting a tactic into season one and then not doing much, where it's the easiest level, then you're probably going to get away with it. It's going to get harder, as we've seen, just to put a tactic in and expect to do well when you get further on into your save. And that happens because I think that the most important thing as you go through your save, and as can be seen with this test, was it's really important to have your squad morale high, because that is the most important thing. Your relationships with the players, especially the team leaders, it's good if it, in their profiles they're saying that they're extremely close to you. Because they'll back you and they will get you out of trouble at the end of the day. And so I think that's probably what I've learned is the most important thing. That's squad cohesion and their level of support for you. You've got to maintain that all the way through your save. And then that's really the next most important thing, as we've seen here, is the better the players you have, the more chance you have of success. It's not going to be just put a tactic in there later on and then expect to get success. You're going to have to later on have better quality of players, and you're going to have to somehow find better quality of players against all the odds of finding them. And that means that your scouting has got to be set up absolutely perfectly. So to be successful, you've got to understand what you're doing with your scouting team. You're also going to need better coaches, and you're going to need better medical facilities, because FM is going to throw injuries at you all the time. It's not going to help you in season 8 anymore as it did in season 1 and 2. So the better players you've got, the more chance you have of success. Your tactic will help, of course, and you will reach a certain level, and 12th was the level that Newport could reach. And that's due to the budget constraints and due to our reputation only being 3.5 stars. And we're simply offering players to come here and they're turning us down because we're not good enough for them. And in-game management has also become much more important. You need to rotate your players, and that's what I think this test was telling me. Rotate your players or be doomed. And you need to be able to adapt. And one tactic is not going to be enough anymore. It might be in season one, but it's not going to be enough anymore. You're going to have to adapt and be able and show the game that you're able to adapt and change the ways, change the system, change the way that you do things, both in-game and pre-game. And you're going to have to plan games a lot better than you did in season one. So there's many, many factors that are more important than just the tactic. Of course, I'm not saying the tactic's not important. It's very important. And I wonder, had I played that, would I finished in 16th, or would I have done slightly better? I suspect I would have done slightly better than the assistant manager. But also, I think it's also important that teams need to grow together. And I think that the game is trying to tell us, and every save that you do in this game, that all the boards are saying, we want to sign players under the age of 21 or 23. And I think it's really important that you allow a side to grow together, rather than making 7 or 8 changes every transfer window, allowing your players to actually grow together and not start, and don't star chase. Just because you happen to have a 3-star player doesn't mean that he's not going to do a great job for your team. And so the instinct is to sell him and then to go out and buy a 4-star player who then takes 2 years before he's able to do the job that player is able to do. So I think I've learned that. I think I need to keep the team together and let them grow together and work as a unit together. Teams that do play together for longer, I think, will do much better. So transfer windows, I think I've learned to limit what I do in transfer windows and to take only players who I'm absolutely sure I need to bring in, rather than go star chasing anymore just to get an extra star on the team sheet. And I think that's pretty much what I've learned from this. A tactic is not enough. There are so many other parts of the game that have to come together with the tactic, that although you can get away with just putting a tactic into a team and letting it go in season one and maybe even season two, I think as you progress through the game, remembering it is a computer game and each level season will get more difficult and more difficult. And so as you get into the game and you're learning different parts of the game, it then becomes much more of a tougher challenge for you as each season goes by. And going back to, oh, I'll just play this great tactic and then we'll be fine, is not going to work for you anymore. You have to be much more adaptable. You have to let your team grow together. And you have to maintain morale above any other thing in the game. And then if you can, then your team will get you through tough times. That's it for this video. I hope you found it as fascinating as me. The results left me speechless for a while. I really did think it was going to do a lot better than it did. I think it needs a lot more research into this. And hopefully you guys let me know what you think. I mean, try it out for yourself and see what kind of results you get. And that's it for this video. Don't forget, if you're new to the channel and you like FM, then like, watch, comment and subscribe and help us to grow and help us to support the very worthwhile cause that you can see scrolling at the top. And I'm going to be starting a new save very, very soon. So all the more reason to hit that subscribe button. And so I will see you all in a couple of days in the brand new save, somewhere in the world.